Rusty is smiling. For those of you who didn't know him, he was an awesome role model. He was a role model for a life well lived during and after one's primary work career. Everything that Rusty did had a purpose. Now, Rusty was raised in Jesuit schools, so some would say it was his calling. The purpose was simple. It was to unselfishly care for others, very much like our first responders do every day on their jobs. It was always about helping other people and never about himself. In fact, if you told him and thanked him, he would get all, he was bashful about it, and he would deflect it back to the people that he was helping. He would say, no, it's not me, it's the cops and the firefighters. Well, Rusty and I had a very common bond, and that's the city of New Orleans. Thank you. Rusty was born and raised there, and I went to Tulane University, met my wife there, and I'm on the board of trustees. Now, I happen to know firsthand that the people from New Orleans are not saints, despite that they happen to call their football team the Saints. Figure that out. He loved to eat, he loved to drink, he loved to cook, tell tales, and have a good time. As they say in New Orleans, le bon temps roule, let the good times roll. But New Orleans also know how to take care of each other, so after Hurricane Katrina, you can imagine Rusty went back to New Orleans and turned himself into just a Herculean helper for everything that was New Orleans. Food, wine, housing, you name it, Rusty did it. Rusty's Louisiana cooking schools led him into the restaurant business, and he became a wine connoisseur. Interesting. And he was well known from Napa to Sonoma to Burgundy to Bordeaux, and he had annual wine auctions of which we were the prime beneficiaries, and he raised millions of dollars. And the wines were donated by friends of Rusty. He relentlessly connected with people. People in the sports world, people in the food and wine business, and people on Wall Street. And he'd be the first to say that he had no idea what people did on Wall Street. But he was happy that they were good at it because he knew, and he was embraced by them, that they would contribute to his cause. Rusty was a true road warrior. He was never in one place more than a week or two. And he had thousands of admirers. As we all know, he was not very technically savvy at all. However, he was a great social networker for his causes. I met Rusty 25 short years ago as a guest at my first benefit dinner and was just blown away by this cause, supporting families of fallen New York City police firefighters. I mean, how can any New Yorker not be blown away by this cause? I mean, really? So you see, I was born in Jackson Heights, Queens. Thanks again. Three subway stops from Shea Stadium. Growing up, I loved and lived the Mets. In fact, when I was a kid, on the side panel of a quart of Tropicana orange juice, there was a coupon. And if you cut out this coupon, if you got 25 of them, you got a free ticket up in the yellow seats. All we did was drink orange juice. Breakfast, lunch, dinner, you name it. I think I turned orange. And while no one can forget my 69 Mets, Rusty's 70s Mets with Tom Seaver, Jerry Kuzman, Tug McGraw, and Bud Harrelson were great, and they were my team. His 80s teams with Keith Hernandez, Daryl Strawberry, Mookie Wilson, and Ron Darling were also awesome. So who could ever have imagined that me, a boy from Jackson Heights, could call Rusty Staub my friend? As they say in Metsdom, you gotta believe. Well, before and after some of our board meetings, I would sometimes grab a bite with Rusty. We'd be walking around Manhattan or we'd go into a restaurant, and everyone, and I mean everyone, would point to Rusty and say, well, that's Rusty Staub, or they'd pull him over and they'd talk to him or ask him questions. You know, you think I was walking with Derek Jeter or Walt Frazier, but it was Rusty Staub, my Rusty Staub. So they would always say, well, do you remember the game, blah, blah, blah. And Rusty would look up in the air and he'd say, oh yeah, I remember that game. It was sunny. The wind was blowing gently from right field to left field. I got a 3-2 inside curve and bam, I hit it out of the stadium. And you could just see the people just blown away that he knew that. I couldn't tell if he was lying or not. To me, it was just amazing. About 2.5 years ago, before Rusty's death in March, Rusty had a major heart attack flying back from an Irish golf outing. And he got the heart attack on an United Airlines flight and had to turn around and go back to Dublin. He recuperated in Ireland for about a month. And then, as only Rusty Staub would say, he said, well, I guess the good Lord decided that my work on earth wasn't finished yet. So that's why I'm here. And he spent the next 2.5 years doing the Rusty, networking, raising money, doing what he could do. I said Rusty had extra innings. So at this year's annual picnic at Citi Field, which we do annually for our families and their friends, we had 1,000 people. And in the old days, Rusty used to cook the ribs himself, and it was great. But the Mets had he did die in March, and this was probably June. And the Mets had a special tribute, and they planted a tree outside now Citi Field. And they said they were gonna have this special patch, a little round patch that they're all gonna have on their uniforms that says Rusty, in memorial to Rusty. And that was great. And it's too bad the Mets didn't do quite as well, but it was nice that they had Rusty on his shirt, on his blazer all year. So we gave out our t-shirts, as we always do. And then it just seemed to us that there's more that we can do to celebrate Rusty and honor Rusty. We need our own tribute shirt to Le Grand Orange. So tonight, and tonight only, working with the Mets organization, we have this shirt. Being well modeled. This is a real baseball jersey. Keith Hernandez could verify that's a Mets jersey. Says Mets. Has the patch. Has the dinner. Has Rusty's name on the back. You can only get this here tonight. Custom made, 4 sizes. Pretty cool. $1,000 each, and you could have your own Rusty shirt. Tonight only. Now, I know you're all saying, wow, it's $1,000. Now, wait a minute. I'm buying 3 of these shirts. One for me, one for each of my 2 grown Yankee fan daughters who admired Rusty Staub. Now, I know some people don't really wear these kind of shirts. Fine. You can frame it, put it in your office, in your man cave. You can put it in your she shed. I don't really care. I want you to buy one of these shirts. Just that simple. Now I figure there's 900 guests here tonight. And if I could sell 100 of these shirts tonight, we're gonna raise $100,000. That'd be good, wouldn't that be good? I hear some applause for that. So, if the technology's working, you're gonna get a little ping on your phones that let you push some buttons and buy one of these shirts. Or 2 of these shirts or 3 of these shirts. I'm sure they make great Christmas and holiday gifts. If that doesn't work, if your phone doesn't ping, on the back of your program is our auction website. You can buy one there. If you don't want to go to a website, we have people walking around who'd be happy to take your order, or in the back of the room, they'll take your order. This is about raising money. This is about honoring Rusty. This is about wearing this shirt every time you come to our picnic. And I know some of you come to our picnic. I'm wearing mine to the picnic. I want to see you wearing yours. Thank you very much.